You have 12 containers of yogurt, and you're going to eat 2 containers per day. Create a function that represents the amount of yogurt remaining, and it asks, what are the constraints? What is the best representation for the domain? So really, there are 3 questions here. The first one is create a function. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make a graph of the situation first. So we have 12 containers of yogurt. That's the initial amount right here. So I'm going to put a point on this graph. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, right here. That means you have 12 containers of yogurt, haven't eaten any. So you're eating 2 per day. So on day 1, you're going to eat 2 yogurts. That means you have 10 left. Day 2, you're going to eat 2 more. Then you eat 2 more. So the amount of yogurts for each day is decreasing by 2. And that 2 is your rate of change, 2 containers per day. So create a function that represents this. Well, it looks like we have a linear pattern here. We have a constant rate of change. So it's going to be like this, y equals mx plus b, where m is your rate, and b is the initial amount. Okay, so we have 12 containers of yogurt. That's the initial amount. And 2 containers per day. For each day, you're taking away 2 containers of yogurt because you're eating them. So really, minus 2 per 1, or your rate is negative 2. So negative 2x plus, and your initial amount is 12. So the input x represents the number of days. So I guess I could label this on the graph. And this is the number of yogurt, which is y. So hey, we'll just leave that as y. So you input the days, your output is yogurt. Here is our function. What are the constraints? Well, a constraint is a limiting factor. And really, the only thing limiting here is the amount of yogurt that you have. So you can't eat more yogurt than you have. Okay, so your constraint is the amount of yogurt you have. Okay, third, what is the best representation of the domain? Now, what we'd like to do here normally is we like to draw a line through these points. I know there's something about points on a graph, they just need a line or a curve through them. But if we're looking at the actual situation here, a line doesn't work, because if you were to draw a line, that would mean you'd have a point, say, right here, and that would be half a day. You would have 1 less yogurt. And that's possible. I mean, maybe you would eat 1 yogurt at noon, another 1 at dinner or something like that. But what if you go right here, 3/4 of a day? That would mean that you would have, let me see, that would be 10 and a half yogurts left. And I don't think you're going to be sitting there gradually munching on yogurt all day long. You're probably just going to eat a yogurt in one sitting. So the point here is that this line, a continuous line, would not actually fit the real world situation, because you're not going to continuously eat tiny, tiny amounts of yogurt all day long. So what does that mean for the domain? The domain is just going to be the data points. Okay, and those data points are integers, so we could write it this way. So we could say, we always use curly brackets for domain. So what are the x values? There's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6. So we could just say this. That would be our actual domain. Or we could talk about a representation of the domain being integers. That's what these numbers are, really. So we could say that x is between 0 and 6 inclusively, and we could say x is an integer. Either of these would be correct. And really, the big idea here is that you can use integers to represent this function. You don't need a continuous function line here, because it's not a continuous situation. This is called discrete, when you just have data points here. Okay, so either one of these would really be correct. You could say it's 0 through 6, but this way is probably a little bit better for now. It's a little more general. Talking about, you know that there are integers involved here. So this is probably the best way to do it.